What's up, everybody? A Spirit with a Gun here from Sleepless Nights with another episode on No Man's Sky. When we left off in the last episode, we went on kind of a crazy adventure goose chase type of thing over to a ruin where we got some vision thingamabobber that I'm really not sure how it affects the grand scheme of things. But we're going to talk to our Exocraft guy. Thank you, Traveler. For this, they call the followers of Null heretics. Grah! With the discovery, you have vindicated the actions of 1,000 martyrs, Traveler. You deserve your reward. You deserve the Colossus, the largest exocraft in my arsenal. Use it and strike terror upon our enemies. The technician gives me the Colossus geobay schematic. The Viking believe that their ancestor Herc received wisdom from a great monolith, initiating a war against the sentinels and slaying Null the objector. The monolith I discovered proves that this history is a lie. Null was honored with a vision, whilst Herc had been met with only silence. And in its jealousy, Herc murdered Null. Yet I am left with questions. I am left thinking of the creature I felt watching me. I am left with dread. Accept the blueprint. You take the blueprint, thanking the technician for all they have done. I'm assuming this is going to end his quest line. I'm not sure, unless he's got more upgrades. I have translated Null's testament to my brethren, Traveler. What you have learned this day will spread amongst the Viking. It will change our people for the better. Grah! And if violence is required, so be it. You are not as pathetic as I once believed. Thank you! You are no longer interloper. You are one of us, now until the end of time itself, enthroned in the glory of the Colossus. The technician waits anxiously to see my Colossus exocraft in its full glory. I watch as they forge an upgrade for my exocraft mining laser. Surrounded by schematics and charts, they could have departed upon my discovery of the monolith. Their heresy is now truth, and although there are those among the Viking who will still pursue them, the cultists of Null will find themselves with new power in this galaxy. Yet still the technician has remained, promising to assist me as I assisted them, until such time as I no longer require their services. Okay. So I expected that to be the end of it, but I guess not. Now I definitely want to keep my nomad, so we're going to park it over here. Now, let's see if this works the same way as the other one did. Nomad, Roamer, Colossus. Perfect. It works. Ooh. My. Okay, well. Oh my goodness gracious. Is it? It's actually got more storage than my starship. That's awesome. And it comes with the mining laser. Well, now that's cool. I still think I like the Nomad the best, but... Alright, so I built this, so let's see what he has to say. Okay, we did all that, so let's see what he has from here. Grah, then why do you stand here, Traveler? Go, subjugate this world with its power, and here is an exocraft vehicle laser upgrade, and blah 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 blah. Okay, detritium and zinc. See if he's got anything else for us, or if that's the last piece of the puzzle. Forgive me, Traveler, I am tired. I have almost exhausted the limits of my work, but soon you shall have mastery of this planet's signals and the speed with which to reach any threat. I require only sufficient nanite clusters to build the final blueprints. Grah, the employment has been one of glory. The technician requires more nanite clusters to create an upgrade for my exocraft signal booster. Something is wrong. Some time ago, I saw the Viking with an image of their family before they performed some ritual to erase such attachments from their mind. As I approach now, I see that same image. The technician stares at it, blinking for a few moments, with an empty expression. When it notices me, it removes the photograph from the display. We do not speak of it again. I do not wish to awaken its pain. So maybe the mind wipe memory eraser thingy did not work so well. Alright, so I guess let's see how fast this thing moves. Oh my. I mean, it's not awful, But it's pretty bad. It's pretty bad in the moving department, let's just be honest. But I mean, that makes sense. It's supposed to be like this gigantic truck thing, and like the Nomad has no inventory space. Speaking of inventory space, I can probably do one more upgrade, and I'm almost thinking, even though I have the one of these, it's either the mining laser or the, let's just transfer this real quick. Oh, and I found a loophole, by the way, around the whole starship switcheroo thingy. If you highlight an open block and then hit transfer, you can actually pull from your ship or your exocraft. Now, the only bad part is it doesn't really tell you which inventory you're pulling from. I just happen to know that that was my exocraft one, because that's all it had. But still. Okay, so I have a mining upgrade, and now I have a cannon upgrade, both of which just require detritium and zinc. But I'm almost wondering if I'm just going to leave this slot open, and then basically upgrade it for the new, what is it? The signal booster, because then I'd have a +3, or whatever it would end up being. Signal booster. So let's look for drop pods, abandoned structures, depots. I'm trying to think what would have nanite stuff. Let's try abandoned structures. See what that gets us. Where are you? How far out are you? 3 minutes? Not bad. And I will say, while I think, obviously, using your ship over an exocraft is actually faster, I do find there are kind of merits to using the exocraft. For example, like this, you can find a lot of resources this way as you're just driving along that you might have missed if you were flying and not close enough to the surface to see what was going on. Oh, and I also found a decent way to get out of these if the edge is not... It's to do that! It's so much fun! I love doing that. Oh my gosh, though, and all the iron. Like, just iron for days if you could actually mine all this. This is detritium. I don't know, mining upgrade would probably be a good idea. And I do think if you have a full inventory, I think it goes to your exosuit. Or does it go to your ship? I think it goes to your ship. I have 45 and 5. So let's see what this does. We'll do a little bit of experimenting. It might not even collect at all, actually, now that I'm thinking about it. 45 and 5. Okay, so it doesn't collect at all. Well, that kind of sucks. See, that's the thing. The Nomad is probably really good for exploring. Whereas the Colossus would be the best for, like, mining, because you've got... I got more slots in that than I do in my ship. And that's not really having to do with upgrades or anything, it's just slot numbers. I have 22 in my ship, I have 24 in the Colossus, so... Whee! I do love the Nomad's, like, coasting ability, it's great. But I like collecting plutonium when I see it. Ooh, what is that? Is that a knowledge stone thing? I think. I guess I should keep the normal scan going too, just to see if I pick up any any things. Wait a minute. Is that another one, or is that... I can't tell if that's a knowledge stone or not. It is! Aha! Look at me and my instincts. Oh, and by the way, I mentioned in the last episode it would have been cool if they actually made a language, and somebody in the comments of my last video actually pointed out that they kind of did, in that when you're being talked to, by other aliens that you don't know their language, it comes up in alien speak, basically. And then as you learn words, then it replaces them with your native tongue. So, by effect, if you're looking at what the random words actually were... Ooh, we got some air on that one. They are actually... Wait a minute, did I pass this? Or have I already been here? I might have already been here, because the icon that I'm going towards is kind of gray. It shouldn't be. Yeah, I'm thinking we already went here before. Out the way! Please, thank you. Yeah, we've been here before. That's not cool. Oh wait, no, it says undiscovered. Huh? Hold up. How is this undiscovered if the icon was grayed out like I've been here? Have I been here and I just didn't activate the waypoint, maybe? I'm confused. I mean, this looks like the place that I was not too long ago. Yeah, the console's been used. This isn't... Yeah, I've been here before. What the heck? I guess I just didn't activate the... I guess I just didn't activate the little beacon waypoint thingy. Or this stone. Which I totally knew about. Operational. Okay. So we need to find... What do I need? I need 100 nanite clusters. I have 42. I'm kind of tempted to just go after some sentinels, because they drop nanite clusters when you kill them. So I'm a little tempted to do that, actually. Because I don't really know where else to go to get nanite clusters, because you have to find... you have to, like, find the busted ships and stuff like you did before, but rather than giving you new blueprints and things, now they just give you the nanite clusters, but you still have to find all those things. Maybe I could use my scanner... Scanner recharging. Oh, there we go. Maybe scan for drop pods? Or depots? I don't really know. I guess depots are going to be mining resources, and scan for research. Let's try a drop pod. Let's see what it has for us. Over... Because usually... Oh, there's a sentinel. Could have blown him up. How far out are we? 245? Usually, drop pods tend to have some crashed device or something to that effect around them somewhere. Generally. I mean, it's not an exact science, but it's typical. Alright, I'm getting that frame rate motion blur going on a bit, trying to keep up with me flying across the planet. That looks like a depot over there. I guess we could check that out too. You know what's really funny? I ran off again and did not use that beacon, so next time it'll totally say that I haven't found that before. I'm wondering if that's what this is, because it's all smoky. So I'm kind of wondering if I've already been here and trashed the place. That's kind of what it looks like. Once again, it says undiscovered. I think these are already busted. So I'm just gonna activate this just so it... I'm not sure if you discover these. If it'll send you back to them or not. I'm not really sure. Because so far, both of the places that it sent me... Well, I shouldn't say it sent me back to that one, because I just ran across that, but... You know what I mean, though. I don't... I'm not sure if that will fix it, but if I can help it, I'd rather the system not send me back to places I've already been, because it's just inefficient and time-consuming for no reason. I'm still trying to wrap my head around if there's a viability for the exocrafts over just flying places with your ship. Alright, we got to the destination. There's a depot, it looks like. I don't see any crashed pods, unfortunately. Let's just shoot a couple of these guys real quick.
Hostiles approaching. Warning. Sentinel drones activated.
Yeah, where are they coming from? There's the other guy. Oops. Oh, and they drop zinc too. That's right. Somebody in the description of my last video mentioned something about that. Oh my gosh, this thing is going way far away here. Apparently fall damage got buffed up. Alright, there's 9. There's zinc. I don't know where that other pod went. I think it probably stayed about where I shot him down at. It didn't look like it went very far. Compared to the other one that just went flying to places unknown. That's what? Platinum? Okay. Are you the pod thing or are you a plant? You look like a plant. Poo! Oh. Is it this one? Can't tell. Yeah, that looks like it. Okay. So, maybe, by the looks of things, I'm not sure if CH isn't the marker for nanite clusters. Because that's what I keep getting out of those things, and that's what it keeps coming up with. So I'm not really sure about that. Alright. And we might as well check this while we're here. Because I haven't checked these in a while. New slot for 180,000. We're only at 400. Yeah, we might as well. It's not like we're saving up a ton at the moment.
Radiation protection.
Use the extra slots. How much zinc do I have? 22, so I have enough to install another upgrade. But we need more nanites more than anything. I have 60. Maybe I should start handling, actually, what I probably should have done is let them actually come after me, rather than taking them all down before they could send for backup. Oh wait, there's some! You couldn't find that before, scanners, huh? Nice, 25. Well, that was helpful. Because now, actually, I only need to kill, like, 2 sentinels, and we should be good. Seeing any more. Oh, wait, there's a sentinel. I was gonna say, I'm not seeing any more of the machinery stuff. Alright, let's just handle you. I shot my own ship. Stand still, you jerk. I don't like these things, they roll everywhere. Seriously, couldn't you have just rolled straight the other way and not rolled down this hill forever and always? I don't even know where it went now. I mean, the good news is I lost the other sentinel without really trying, but I also lost the pod. Where did it go? That's gonna drive me nuts. Where did this thing go? Oh, it got stuck behind over here, I guess. There you are, jerk. Oh, and it gave me a neutrino module. Man, that's not what I wanted. Ah, why can I never grab these things when they're rolling past me? That's so annoying. Stop giving me neutrino modules. I need nanite clusters. Dagnabbit. I mean, thanks for the zinc, but it's not what I needed. Alright, 93! So close! I guess it didn't get a signal out. I thought I was gonna get more bad guys. We are not really in an opportune spot here either. Whee! I love when you're on an incline with this ship and you just boost and jump at the same time and basically just go flying. Like now. Whee! Oh, we're up really high, actually. This would be a good spot to leap off of. If we can pull it off. How about this spot would be good. Woo! Oh, jeez. Major error. Oh, dang. Stuck on a tree. I figure, since we only need, like, less than 10 of the clusters, what I'll end up doing is kind of heading back. Oh yeah, we have a horn, too! I thought that was a nice little comedic touch. Oh! Oh, goodness. I don't know where I am. I'm stuck on something. What was I gonna say? Oh, yeah! On our way back, I'll probably just clip another sentinel or two. Get us the stuff that we need. What is this one? How is this undiscovered? It's probably the same one that I was at before. Like always. I always end up going back to the same places somehow. Or not. Little different looking. Actually, I could see this being like some space hobo's house. What are you doing? Perfect. Well, would you look at that? Just what the doctor ordered. What do we have? 102. Perfect. Alrighty, so at this point, we are back at our base. I figured since we had what we needed, I'd just go ahead and skip back here, because it was basically a beeline. Alright, now, let's see what we can do here. I have the nanite clusters. The technician uses the clusters to create the final exosuit, or exocraft signal booster. Allows for additional building types to be acquired by the Exocraft signal booster. We have everything but the carite sheets we need four of. Shouldn't be a problem. Let's see if this is the end of his. Here, traveler, if you have constructed a nomad exocraft, this final acceleration module shall be yours. Oh, I need to switch the base. Okay. Our work is concluded, but every end is a beginning. I am too weak to travel as I once did, too tired to continue my pilgrimage. With your leave, I shall remain here to stand by your side against your enemies. Grah! Woe betide those who would transgress against us. The technician has a final reward, an acceleration module upgrade for my nomad exocraft, once I have constructed its geo bay. There are few in my travels that I have grown to understand as individuals, but this Viking has shown me purposes, secrets I did not know existed in this universe. They have shown me the promise of a different future, of a time of strife and glory.
Shut up.
Incoming storm.
The technician has struggled their entire life to achieve their goal of finding Nal's testament. What I heed or head towards, I do not know. Okay, so really quick, let's do a switcheroo here and go back to our... where is it? Nomad. Okay. So I should just be able to talk to him at this point. Alright, I possess the Nomad Exocraft. Grah, the acceleration module upgrade is now yours. Ba-boom. Increases efficiency of plasma injector coupled to the engine that allows short bursts of speed. Okay. So that seems specific to the Nomad? Maybe? Let's get in this one. So it has a plus one. Oh, it does have a plus two. Okay. So I guess you just had to have the Nomad selected, but it's not your required one. Okay, so let's see. I have 42 zinc over here. I have 98 zinc over here. Ooh, that's good. I didn't know I had that much. Let's grab that. And we'll go ahead and grab the iron. I guess that was out of my ship. Okay, and I think it's 50. Oh, wow. Ran that one pretty close. All right, so mining laser. Let's go over here to our gigantic resources of iron. And get some of these iron deposits going. How much is that, actually? 45. I feel like there used to be a bigger resource of them. Oh, you know what? It was these guys, but they changed them to be the detritium. That's what it was. Those used to give like 300 or something of iron. But I guess 50 a pop is not a bad haul either. How much can this hold? Oh, of 500. Oh. I didn't realize that the Exocraft's inventory was that high. Okay. That's cool. I will say I do like mining from the ship because you can just hold it. There's no, like, overheating or anything. So it makes for a little bit more of a convenient mining experience, I should say. Okay. 325, more than enough. So let's grab it, put it over here. Oh, right.
Storm clearing.
Let's throw the neutrino modules that don't stack over into our ship. Along with that, too. Okay, so what do I need? Four? What they said? Oops. I need to get the rest of that out of there. Okay, so for me, I think I'm gonna do this one. Now, I don't know if you'd actually need both of these, as far as if now that you have the plus two, do you need the plus one? I'm not really sure, to be honest, but what does this let us do? Scan for alien structures, scan for ruins, abandon. So now we can actually look for alien structures and ruins. I guess that's all that added. And then we have abandoned structures, drop pods, resources, and depots, which was there before. I was kind of hoping that we could do the search for ship, like transmission signals. But I guess not. I guess that's not something we can scan for, which is unfortunate. But yeah, I might end up reconfiguring the Exocrafts a little bit in terms of, like... Actually, I don't know if there's any way I can reconfigure this one other than to reduce the plus one of the acceleration one, but or take off the weapon maybe or something, because if I have a mining laser is virtually useless on a ship with a full inventory, because when you mine it, it's just being deleted. It's not going anywhere. It's not like it's sending it to your ship or your personal inventory, so it's kind of one of those, what's the point of having a mining laser on an exocraft with a maxed out inventory. So I don't know. I like the maneuverability of the Nomad. It's a lot of fun. Like, I can't really see myself using the Colossus all that much, because the Colossus is just so slow that it's like I might as well use my ship and just fly around. But at the same time, you could have everything fully upgraded on that thing. So I'm not really sure. How to do all that. I'm guessing he's not going to say anything else after this. Traveler, I've decided a location of monetary interest. Go that you may hone your control of the exocraft. Oh, I've detected location. Track the signal before it disappears so that we may siphon its units. Oh! The technician has hacked a terminal to siphon its units. If I get to the location fast enough, I will be able to transfer the units to my account. They spend their days doing this now, tending to the exocraft and drawing data from interplanetary networks. Sometimes I see them walking out into the planet itself to explore, but such times are rare. The technician is content with this retirement, engaging in its fugitive activity? For the pleasure of the chase, no longer for the necessity of survival. So that's interesting. I didn't want to activate it because I don't really feel like I have time to do that. Maybe what I'll do is strip the weapon off of this and add the extra accelerator, and or maybe take the mining laser. That might be something I'll do. I might take the mining laser off and put the +2 accelerator on this, and then it'll have a weapon, but it won't have a miner tool. Maybe that's what I'll do. And then this guy can be like our miner type thing, I guess. I don't know. Let me know what you guys think about all that in the comments. In the meantime, I hope y'all enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, and I will see you all next time. Peace.